An anticipation guide is a series of statements that I usually have the kids read before they do an activity and then after they do the activity. I try to come up with ideas or statements that are maybe a little bit unusual, maybe that they're going to strongly disagree with. And then I have the students either read through them silently, or if there's a lot of new vocabulary, I'll read that for them. And they'll either write an A if they agree with a statement, or they'll write a D if they disagree with the statement. And then at the end of the activity, we do the exact same thing, and they see whether or not they have agreed or disagreed and if they've changed at all. And the idea is that, you know, we're challenging some of their assumptions and then they've learned something at the end. I like anticipation guides for a couple of reasons. For one, they are an opportunity for us to introduce some vocabulary, and our students struggle with especially science. It's a new language for them. We like to have some way that we can introduce that to them at the beginning. And also it activates any sort of knowledge that they have prior to doing the activity. They want to think about it and try to see if anything has changed by the end.